Ah, nothing like a good book to pass the time and with no one to bother me.
Hey there, Crystal.
Sigh, why did I have to jinx that? Whatever, so what do you need, Sonic?
Sorry if I was interrupting you, but there are a couple of people outside your door. I didn't let them in without your consent, but they said they are looking for a place to stay.
They need a place to stay? Geez, at this point, my fucking house might as well be a hotel. Anyway, thank you for letting me know. I'll take it from here.
Do you think they'll let us stay yet? I mean, we can just look for a new place.
We can refer the new place, so this is our best bet. Either they let us stay, or we look for a hotel room.
God, this success. That cocksucker of a landlord kicked us out because we wouldn't pay him for the month. We wasn't paying that dick anything until he fixed that damn gas leak. Actually, the more I think about it, I'm quite happy that we got kicked out. I swear I was starting to suffocate in there.
You know what? You're right. I was starting to get headaches as well. God knows what would have happened if we stayed there any longer. So fuck that place. Hello! I heard that you two are looking for a place to stay. But before that, I need your names and the reason why you want to live here. Hi. My name is Ichiro the Lighthog, and the guy behind me is Ichiro the Wolf. We was wondering if you could let us stay, because the place we lived in before was just horrible. Our previous apartment had a gas leak and our landlord refused to fix it. We didn't pay him for the month until he had it fixed, therefore he kicked us out. To be honest, we're very glad we did, because we was starting to feel sick.
Yeah. And I swear, if I see that bitch asshole again, I'll kick his fucking ass. We could have died.
I see. Well, in that case, sure you guys can stay. I'll go over the rules with you later. For now, I'll show you your rooms. This will be your room, Rhea.
This is a pretty sweet room. Thanks.
And this will be your room, Ichiro.
Oh, hell yeah. I got the best room in the house, bitches.
I don't know about that, but I gave you a room that I thought would suit you. So enjoy. Okay. Now that I got that taken care of, and no one to bother me, I can finally have some alone time. Just me and my book, no one else. You know what? I might as well put some music on while I'm at it.
Nah, baby, nah, baby, nah, baby.
Take your love away from me, I'll go crazy.
No,
I'll go insane.
Your problems, baby, and I've got mine. Let's just spend it all by putting it together.
Sorry. Just wanted to thank you for letting me and Rhea live here. This place is so cool.
You're welcome. I know I said I'll give you guys the rules later, but I'll leave this one on the table right now. Do not come into my room without knocking or without my consent, okay?
Got it. Do you mind if I help myself to something in the fridge?
Sure, go ahead. Just make sure you don't make a mess.
Bet. I'll let you get back to whatever you were doing.
Hey Crystal, I was wondering if...
God fucking damn it! What is with you fuckers coming in my room without my permission? I just want to read my porn in peace! I'm getting sick and tired of you bastards coming in here during my private time! Why is it so hard for you to remember a simple goddamn rule?
Okay. I'm sorry. I promise I'll remember to knock next time. Just don't pull the trigger. Wait. Did you say porn? Okay, never mind. I'll leave.
You know what? Next time, I should just lock my fucking door whenever I want to be left alone so that people can't come in my room all willy-nilly. It's not that hard to follow one simple goddamn rule. Ichiro was an exception because he didn't know. Anyway, let me just lock my door and get back to my book. Hey Ria, can I ask you something?
Sure, what is it, Crystal?
You're a Lighthog, right? Does that mean you have the power of electricity?
Yes, I have the power of thunder, lightning, whatever you wanna call it. Why do you ask?
Well, I was kind of hoping that you could teach me how to use it. I have the power of fire, but lightning has always been my second favorite element that I wanted to learn. Will you teach me?
HM. I don't know. I've never really taught anyone. But I guess it could be good practice. Okay then, I'll teach you. Meet me at the park tomorrow at 10 a.m., okay?
Okay. Thank you, Ria.
Hey, wait, who's the new girl?
Oh, that's Ria. She's our new roommate. There's another one too named Ichiro. By the way, Shadow, I want to apologize for pulling my gun on you. But for God's sake, please knock. Okay?
Yeah, no hard feelings.
Oh, wasn't there something you wanted to ask me before?
Oh yeah. Can I borrow your car for tomorrow? There's somewhere I need to be, and my bike needs to get fixed.
Well, okay. Just be careful with my baby, okay? The keys are in a bowl in the first living room.
Don't worry, I'll take good care of your car when I leave tomorrow.
Okay, let's get started. First, I want to test your strength to see where you stand. So get ready.
You got it. I'll give you a fair warning. I won't hold back.
Neither will I. Alright, that's enough. I think I have a good idea where you stand. I'll teach you what I know.
Sweet! Okay, so what's the first thing you wanna teach me?
Okay, let's start off with something easy first. I'll teach you a move called Electric Flash Strike. This move can send a deadly amount of electricity through your enemy's body. First, I need you to learn how to channel lightning through your body. Focus your chaos energy and try turning it into lightning.
Okay, sounds easy enough.
Focus. Concentrate. Let the power of lightning flow through your body, and then let it out.
So what do I do now?
Oh, right. Hold on for a second. Okay. Now what I want you to do is focus all of your energy into your hand. Then, release all of it into this dummy.
Okay then, I'll give it a try.
Nothing's happening.
Give it a second.
Okay, never mind. Good job, Crystal. You were able to learn the Electric Flash Strike. Keep practicing that move, and you'll master it in no time. Now let's move on. The next move that I'll give you is called Shocking Bullet. It's just a simple chaos blast infused with lightning energy. I'll demonstrate it for you, then you can try it yourself. Okay. Now, watch carefully. You can perform this attack any way you desire. And best of all, it's quick and powerful, and it can be fired from anywhere. See? It's that easy. Now it's your turn. Ready?
Yes! Actually, do you think you could throw in a few more dummies in there for me?
Sure. Knock yourself out.
Shocking bullet!
Very nicely done, Crystal. You're blazing through this like a hot knife through butter. But remember, it takes time to master these attacks. So keep training. Okay, on to the next lesson. Now this isn't an attack, this is more of a defensive skill. It's just a simple force field to protect yourself. It will come in handy if you're being outnumbered or overwhelmed. All you have to do is imagine an energy sphere around yourself. Watch. Alright, now you try. This time, I'm going to attack you, and I want you to try and create a force field to protect yourself. Okay?
Got it! Phew, that was close. But I managed to pull it off.
Now you got some defense to your arsenal. Remember, that barrier is dependent on how much energy you have left. Keep that in mind. Okay, now there's one last thing that I want you to do, and then we'll call it a day. I want you to release all of that power in one blow. This is to help you unlock your full potential. If you can do that, then you will be able to use lightning at max power. Think of it as unlocking a gate. Ready?
Okay, I just hope that I don't end up hurting myself while doing this.
Just relax. You just need focus, that's all. If you can do that, there's nothing to fear.
Okay, okay. I got this. Here goes nothing. Concentrate. Let the power flow through.
Exhausting than I thought it would be. But I managed to pull it off. At least I think I did. Wait. My voice. It sounds a whole lot deeper and my body feels different. The fuck? I changed again. Why the fuck do I keep changing?
Don't worry about that. When you unlocked your full power, it automatically changed your look. That's what happened to me when I decided to stop hiding who I was and just let all of my power go. How do you feel?
Well, to be honest, I wasn't expecting my appearance to change, but it feels pretty damn good. I feel even more powerful than I did before, even with my fire powers. And I have you to thank for that, Rhea.
Hey, it's no problem at all. It was quite fun, and I learned a thing or two along the way. Well, that's it for training today. If you ever want to train with me again, just ask, okay?
You bet. Come on, let's head back home. I'm starting to get hungry.
Where is everyone? Huh? What's this? Did someone leave this out for me? Well, I'm feeling quite thirsty. I guess it wouldn't hurt to have just a taste. Huh, it's kind of got a bitter taste to it, but it's not bad. Wait, I'm feeling strange. Oh god, what's going on with me? Oh thank god, the pain stopped. Huh? Is it just me, or did I just suddenly get taller? And I feel completely different. All of a sudden, I'm having a craving for Fish? What? What happened to me? What did I just drink?
Okay, now to just... I'm Miss, may I ask who you are and what you're doing here? And why do you have that potion in your hands?
Potion? I thought this was some kind of drink that someone left out for me.
Left out for you? What are you talking about?
Mr. Sonic, it's me. Mimi.
The hell? Mimi? Wait. You mean to tell me you drank that potion? That was a growing potion that Tails told me to hold on to.
I think it did more than that. For some weird reason, I'm starting to crave fish.
What? Okay, we'll worry about that later, but what the hell are we gonna tell Crystal?
I don't know. Maybe she won't freak out as much. Maybe.
Freak out about what exactly?
Wait. Mom? Is that you?
Wait. Mimi, is that you? What the actual hell is going on here?
I guess we'll go first. You see, Tails came over and he asked me if I could hold on to a potion that he'd been saving. I had to use the bathroom, so I left it on the table. That's where I made a mistake. Mimi found the potion on the table and she drank it. So that explains why she's taller.
Not to mention my craving for fish. I'm still trying to figure out what's going on with that.
Okay, I see. It's just a little bit to take in. I honestly don't know how to feel right now. But I guess it's not too much of a big deal. At least she looks like she's 10. Now it's my turn to explain. Long story short, Rhea was teaching me how to use lightning. For the last part of our training, I had to unleash all of my power to unlock my full potential. While I succeeded, it also gave me a new look and changed my voice. So that's pretty much what happened.
Alright then. Glad we got all of that confusion out the way.
Agreed. But Sonic, you really need to keep a better eye on that stuff and don't just leave it out in the open. Because if something happened to Mimi, I'd make your life a living hell. Are we clear?
Crystal clear. I'll get it.
Hey Sonic, I came by to tell you that I accidentally gave you the wrong potion. Sometimes, I forget to label them and I end up getting them mixed up. The potion that I gave you was a DNA potion. It makes the individual whoever drinks it change their DNA to someone very close to them.
Oh. Shit.
Huh? What's the matter, Sonic? What did you do?
I'll tell you what he did. Don't even bother lying, I heard everything. You turned my daughter into a hellcat, huh? I'll kick your fucking ass. But you know what? I'll cut you some slack, Sonic, because I don't mind now that Mimi is now my blood daughter. But the main reason I'm kicking your ass is because you fucked with her DNA.
Oh fuck. Get the hell out my way.
Oh no you fucking don't. Get your spiky blue ass back here so I can kick it.
You know, I've never really met your mom before, but she already scares the hell out of me.
Yeah, she tends to be a bit overprotective of me, but in a good way. She's a really nice person when you get to know her.
Well, if you'd like, I can make another potion to turn you back, if you'd like.
No, it's alright. I don't mind. This just means now that me and Mom can finally be a family. She may not be my mom by birth, but she can be my blood, and that's good enough for me. I love her, and nothing will change that.
Well then, if that's what you want, I will respect it.
Get over here, bitch!
Yeah, I think now's a good time to go back inside.
Wait for me.